All right, welcome to the best six videos that book you more speaking gigs. And isn't that what we're all here for, right? Booking more speaking gigs, not only to increase our income, not only to increase our impact of our message, but also to increase speaking gigs. Because isn't it true that speaking gigs beget speaking gigs? The more you speak, the more you speak, and the more opportunities that you have to do so. So that is a fantastic goal. That's a fantastic outcome. Okay, I'm with you, Tim. But how do we get that process started? How can we make sure that it's consistent so that when I step off stage, I'm not immediately unemployed again? I want to make sure I have a process that's not a grind so that every single gig that I get feels like pulling teeth or feels like a grind, just like that. So how can we do that, right? The answer is in today's environment, in today's corporate speaking environment, we can leverage video. You know, it used to be if in the music business, it used to be if you wanted to be a musician, you needed to be discovered by some kind of record label. But now we've got the ability to just record and distribute our own music. We live in the future. It's an exciting time. Same is true for publishing books. You don't need a big publisher to come and discover you. You can just put out a book on KDP. If you want to be a speaker, the same is true. You can just start putting out content. And content marketing is one of the biggest methods and ways of getting speaking gigs. It's not just a trend. It's really one of the core four, as Alex Ramosi says, of getting leads in a way that's consistent, repeatable, and reliable. That's the goal. That's the dream. Video is going to help us do it, because isn't it true that if we want to get booked as a speaker, we have to be seen? And can't we just use YouTube? Can't we just distribute our videos on our own and create them as long as we are consistent with that? So that is our goal today. That is our vision. That is our message. And we're here to introduce to you Happy, our resident video editing and video marketing expert, who's going to help fill us in on some of these ways that we can be more consistent. Welcome, Happy.
Let's go. A virtual high five, a virtual hug to all those people watching out there, and excited to connect.
Love it. Yeah, received and returned. Love that energy. And it's late where you're at in Nepal. So welcome and keep that energy up. We love it. So let's do this, man. Let's start looking at some of that. Let's discuss from your perspective and your take. What if somebody comes to you and says, this all sounds great, I love the idea of using video and leveraging video, but how am I going to create these videos? I'm not out there doing speaking gigs. Where are these videos going to come from?
Love it. Let me say this before we go any further, you know, and this is a statement that you could get tattooed in your heart, maybe, if you want to get successful with speaking. If you want to have them pay you speak, they got to see you speak. Right. And the way you get them to see you speak is by having you on stage or by having them on your phone. And that's the easiest way. Imagine on one way to get 1,000 potential, you know, recruiters, companies, or basically conference hosts in a room trying to listen to your message, you trying to convince them to hire you, or you simply literally making a video out there and 1,000 potential recruiters are seeing your work and you get one right opportunity popping up. Right? That's how it works with videos. You're literally getting into their room, in their comfort space, and making them hear your message so they are convinced to hire you as a speaker, right? And most people have all of these beliefs that if they have to do videos, it's difficult, it's time consuming. I'm not at the stage yet, Tim. How do I make these videos in the first place? And that's what I want to talk to you about, all these myths that are surrounding it, all the truths that can get you into the stage, even if you have no stage experience. And we want to go into all of them one at a time. But yeah, I'm pumped. You can see that.
I love it. And I love how you bring up that analogy of, hey, how would you feel? Like some of our videos, the work that we do together, right? Some of it goes, in my world, what I consider viral, tens, hundreds of thousands of views. And others only have a few thousand. And you think of it in terms of, oh, bummer, I only got a few thousand. Well, what would you do if you had a room full of 1,000 people, an attentive audience of 1,000 people? Do you think you could leverage that opportunity and maybe turn that opportunity into some further gigs? So I love the way of thinking about that. It's not a vanity metric of let's get your views up, let's pat you on the back because you know did good and got viral or whatever. It's really about creating opportunities to, yes, expand your message and expand your reach, but also to turn many of those viewing your videos into direct speaking leads. So let's do it again. I am all ears. I'd love to hear some of these styles of videos that we can create, because it's true, showing up is great, but we can't just show up once. We've got to be consistent. And what you found in your work and in our work together, that consistency is key. You can't make one video and expect video marketing to work for you. So let's talk about how people can be more consistent and using some of these different types of videos.
Love it. So basically, here's, you know, and when I share this, it comes in from the experience of generating over 25 million views per speaker glance in the last 6 months alone. You know, I'll give examples of how we generate
25 million speaker views in the last 6 months alone, speaker video views in the last 6 months alone. I mean, my goodness. Again, I don't know how many thousands of clients it would take for that. Happy. I mean, you mentioned one specific case study. Go ahead. I'll let you continue on that and share some of the numbers of just what one speaker can expect from views. I mean, I cut you off. You were starting to get into some of the numbers.
Yeah, that's what I love, your excitement, Tim. And that's why it's getting the audience into this as well. I love it. So basically, I'll show you examples. If you have no experience of creating videos, what the process looks like. And for some of our clients, which I'm going to share you a few case studies today, we generate anywhere between 200 to 300,000 views with their videos. And this leads to 5 to 10 speaking gigs every single month consistently for them. You touched upon the word consistency, and that's something super important I want to talk about. See, there are two factors into the game. You know, the one is consistency, the other is quality, right? There are things in your control and there are things in your not in your control. There are people who complain about, well, algorithm is not favoring me. I'm sorry, but BS on that. You know, there are things that you can control: the quality of the video you create and the consistency. How often do you show up no matter what? And when I say consistency, most people think they have to be filming videos, they have to be on stage to have those videos. The truth is, to be consistent, you don't have to consistently do the work. Listen to this carefully. You need to have a system, right? A system in place that takes care of the stuff. And when it comes to quality, there are a few important things I want to touch upon, Tim, before I go ahead, show examples of different styles of videos that can be done. Every single time you create a video, it's not about creating a video, but you're putting your brand out there, right? If you create a video of you not looking the way you want to look in front of your audience, it is going to impact how they perceive you. Even if you reach out to 1 million people and you are in a place where you don't want to be seen, or you're doing something that you don't want to be seen doing, it results to nothing. In fact, if there's potentially someone looking at hiring and they search you up and see a video of you in that way, that might decrease your chances of getting hired, because they just realize they are not of the brand perception that they thought you were, right?
So I'm going to share you a few. There's so much. Yeah. So much to unpack. So 200 to 300,000 views per month resulting in 5 speaking gigs per month. There's your speaking business right there. Now, a lot of people think content marketing has to be Alex Hormozi or, Grant Cardone or Gary Vaynerchuk putting out hundreds of pieces of content per week. That's one form of consistency for us in our speaking business when we only need 5 clients per month. I mean, hundreds of thousands of views ain't too shabby. Real quick, how much of that is paid advertising to generate those leads, and how much of that is organic? Because again, a lot of times the people throw out numbers and they just buy those numbers.
It's $1,000 in ads minus $1,000. It's all organic. I'm sorry. It's all organic.
So $1,000 per month minus $1,000 per. So all organic outreach. And that is huge. So when we think of content marketing, I love that you said be consistent. And I love that you said quality is important, because even though your videos are free for the viewer, people still judge you on your free content. And if they think to themselves, gosh, you know, if this is what he looks like, and this is what they show up as, and this is what her branding looks like, then you're dead in the water. Message. So, you know, that is huge and important to look professional. And there's also this component and this piece of some people, when they try to look professional, they add in editing and fancy, flashy this and that. What I love about the work that we've done together is you've been able to enhance my message, because isn't that what people are booking? They're booking the experience that they're going to have on that I'm going to deliver on stage, and they're booking the outcomes from the messaging. So when your video editing team comes alongside and adds the right kind of music that does not distract from my message. It's not overpowering. They add in the video overlay, the captions that say, hey, look, even if they're watching on mute, they're still going to get the messaging. And it's not going to be cheesy, twirling in, flying in. It's going to be professionally done. When you add in some of the B-roll, it looks so professional and it enhances the message. It does not detract from the message. So I can see why, you know, these videos are working, and you're also cognizant and you're aware and you're thinking about the algorithms. You're thinking about the right formats. Hey, if this is going to go on Instagram, it's going to look in this format. If it's going to work on LinkedIn, it's going to be in this format. And I just, again, love how all of that's taken care of for me. And, you know, you strategically position my message for success.
For sure, Tim, you know, it's easy. You know, you can talk about what you're talking about, or you can show what you're talking about. And here's some nuggets for the audience, for you, if you're editing your videos on your own. I'm going to give it away, literally. Or you can seek help as well as we talk further. There are a few things when it comes to quality of your videos. And hear me when I say it, with the experience of all of this work, editing can lead to you getting lesser views in your videos if you don't do it right, you know? And I've seen that happen again and again. I see, oh, well, all these things are happening, flashy animation, graphic stuff. Nope. They want to hear you. You want to show your brand, you know? You want to show what your message is, and you want to show yourself. Few key components that I want to quickly touch upon as we touch upon different editing styles and stuff like that, Tim. Number one is subtitles. You know, at this point of time, about 40 to 60% of people, even when they're watching the videos, they have it on mute in Instagram, you know, in YouTube Shorts. So you want to be showing what you're talking about. Number two is you want to take a visual approach, right? Let's say you're talking about a seed coming out of the ground. Well, show it, you know, a quick B-roll. And the rule of thumb, and again, a golden nugget right there, is 30%, 20 to 30% is what the B-roll's quantity should be. 70% should be you speaking, you know, because your goal, again, is not to get only more views, but associate that with your personal brand. So people book you and buy into your message here, buy not in the message, but your message. You are the important factor in that. That's what you want to consider. The third important thing is the choice of music, you know. Imagine you're going to a funeral and there is rock music happening. Just imagine what happens over there, right? That's not what you want to do, you know. Okay. If your message is something that's relating to something that's mourning about, go talk about it. You know, you want to have that music. If that's something celebratory, kick it in, you know. If there's something that you want people to be insightful about, go in with a little slower music piece over there. You want to match the quality of music to the message that you're delivering, right? And one important thing is every single video should end with something empowering. You know, you can talk about problems and end the video. Nope. You know, everyone knows the problem. You want to be a solution because they hire you to solve a problem that they're facing in their organization. And your speaking engagement, your words of wisdom, your gig is their solution to their problem that they know about or they don't know about, right? So these are some things that you want to be careful about. Please, 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 please don't run 100 different things happening in your video. Please don't make it only B-rolls. And of course, little things, and these are the intricacies. You want to use things like dynamic zooms, fast cuts, you know, and all of these can be taken care of with any editing software that you're using, or you can take help of people who expertise into it and help you with it. And with that said, I've been mumbling all of this around. I hope that helps you, but I can get into the different editing styles that we're going to talk about. I'm going to talk about how you can create, and listen to this carefully, create consistent content without creating consistent content, right? How do you use one single video of you speaking or no video of you speaking? And I'm sorry, Tim, I'll have to highlight this, that you don't have to be on stage to create the videos. This is the biggest myth out there for speakers, that you need to have videos of you speaking on stage to be getting these videos to put out there to book your gigs. Ain't happening. You don't need that. And we're going to touch into that, but I'll let you take it from here, and then I'll get into it.
Yeah, no, I love that. I love the idea of show, don't tell. I mean, again, we're marketing ourselves as speakers. We need to be seen speaking. And even if that's direct to camera, we still show our personality. We show our messaging with the proper B-roll. We enhance that with the right music. And all of these things may make people feel something that leads to maybe a like, maybe a share, maybe something that bumps the algorithm that is why these videos are getting so many views, and also why the videos result in speaking engagements as well. So I'd love to see these six different types. Let's talk about some case studies. Let's look at some actual videos to see what we're talking about. Let's practice what we preach and show, don't tell. So I'll let you take it away and look at some of these video examples to give people some inspiration and let them know, hey, this is a lot easier than many speakers think it is, as long as we're strategic, as long as we are consistent. So let's dive in.
Drums rolling. Let's go. Awesome. One important thing you want to understand is when you are starting your journey as a speaker, trying to market yourself, you are not going to have videos of you being on stage. And that's where two solutions come in. Number one is you record videos in your camera. I'm going to give you insights on how to do it right. And number two, you can reach out to podcasts and have yourself speaking in them and get that opportunity. And it's so much easier than most people think, and I'm going to touch upon that. But let me go one at a time, Tim, and highlight the six different formats that we're going to talk about. I'll start with the first. Sorry, go ahead.
Hang on a second. You know, we're going to tease them even more, but this is really important. What you just said, getting on podcasts, talking direct to camera. Hey, listen, the activity of creating these videos benefits you, the speaker, right? Before the video even goes out, you're out there on podcast interviews. Before the video goes out, you're talking direct to camera, dialing in your messaging and giving you really multiple shots at the target to figure out what messaging is going to feel right in your mouth, how you're going to communicate and speak about what you speak about. This is reps. This is practice. This is iteration. And that is how the speakers go from good messaging to great messaging. So all along the way, getting to the point of video is beneficial and will maybe even put some dollars in your pocket.
Exactly. The process of making the videos in itself is the result you're going to get as well. Sounds good. I love how you put it, Tim. Love the content. Cool. Now let's get into a few editing styles, and I'm going to touch into each one of them, show you how to do it right, show what not to do in the process of creating those videos, and let's get right into it. The first and the easiest format of videos for you to do, if you have no stage experience, you have never been to a stage, but you want to book gigs, is to talk direct on camera, right? And you want to be, number one, creating content that's solving problem to the exact audience that you're trying to cater, right? Let's say in this case, I'm giving an example of Sam, who's someone who's we're helping with. He is a youth speaker. His message is around motivation to the youths, right? High school students is who he's targeting, middle and high school students. So he wants to be creating content that is something that solves their problem, that they can relate to. Let's say you are trying to target corporates and your message, for example, is around bringing connection. For example, that's what team does. So you want to be talking about how the workplace is a mess. You want to be talking about the competition that exists within the employees and how it is killing them. And how do you solve that problem? You want to talk about how it can lead to extra dollars coming into their pocket just because of them getting the culture right, the connection right within the audience. I'll pull up one single video to give you an example of how different factors build in together to create amazing videos. So let's watch this and let's see how it makes you feel. And let's see how why it made you feel the way it made you feel. A quick 36-second video. Let's play it.
When did you stop doing the things that made you feel amazing? When did you stop meditating? When did you stop journaling? When did you stop stretching your body and taking cold showers? Why aren't you doing the things that you know fill your cup and allow you to show up to the best of your ability? Life is too short to disrespect your body. We all have one freedom in life. It's the freedom to choose. And if the choices you're making are making you feel amazing, it's time to start making some new choices. So what are you waiting for? Go hit that meditation. Go do that yoga. And I'll see you soon.
Okay, Tim, let me ask you this. How did this video make you feel?
36 seconds. I felt two things. Number one, I felt as a member of this person's, you know, not a direct member of their audience, but imagining myself a member of this person's audience, feeling inspired and motivated. But I also felt myself watching this as a speaker and feeling like that's what I want to do more of. That's the type of inspiration that I want to bring to people. And having the freedom, the flexibility, the creativity, the outlet to distribute my message in ways and share what I believe and what I'm passionate about. And man, oh man, capturing that on video is like capturing lightning in a bottle. That's what people hire speakers for. People hire speakers to create transformation in their audiences, and transformation comes from these types of emotional shifts that people make. Again, rooted in content, rooted in ideas, rooted in new ways of thinking. So that's how I felt. I felt part of the audience, and then I also imagined myself being that speaker and just getting charged up and excited about motivating human beings to action.
Exactly. Love it. Now let's break it down really quick about why it made you feel the way. Number one, it was the message and how it started. You know, all the youths out there who are above the age of 18, they feel like they're missing out on life. Like childhood was beautiful, but yeah, I'm getting into this next phase of life. So it was something that they could relate about the things that they are missing out on, right? Number two was the music choice, if you noticed him, right? It is that of nostalgia. It is bringing that feeling. And if you see the little things, every single time something is being talked about, you show it to the audience so they get a little more visual approach. And the 70-30 rule that I talked about, that's something that we've been consistently using into it to make sure it reaches the maximum amount of audience, right? Quick glimpse into another style of video right here in direct to camera is something organic that the audience can feel as well. I'll quickly run through the 16-second video to show you how easy it can be for you to create these videos and how we can help you as well.
Stop wasting your opportunities. Stop wasting them. Once the day's gone, it's gone. So take advantage of it and make choices that move you forward. Lose yourself in the music, the moment, in the person you want to be.
So basically what I'm trying to talk about, Tim, is we have these little moments of inspiration in our daily days. We see something, we find something, maybe your kid talks something out to you, and that makes you feel that pull, right? You want to be capturing those messages as well, you know, something that's close to your heart and solves a problem that your potential client has. Go ahead and make a quick video about it, right? And sometimes it does not have to show the videos because it's like you want to show the organic part of you to the audience as well, right? Yeah. And see how it can be done so simply. Now, if you're out there thinking, well, I know it makes sense, I don't know what the heck to talk about in front of camera, we'll talk about how we could potentially help you literally film the content by understanding what your audience is, by helping you solve the exact specific problem that they're looking for. And literally in a Zoom, in a single hour of Zoom call, you'll be getting 10 videos ready as easy as it is. So Tim, that's what my first site insight is. Filming direct to camera videos. If you have anything else to share, would love to hear, and then we could go into the other styles of videos the audience can get.
Yeah, no, I'm just imagining, you know, those moments when I'm listening to an audiobook and I get inspired. And we all have our phones on us. We all have amazing cameras at our disposal. Hit record and then send them off, or get them edited in such a way where those files can become marketing assets for you. And I love what you said about not just showing your professional side, but also showing the personal side, because people do business with people they know, like, and trust. Invite them into your world. Personal sometimes beats professional, even in the corporate speaking space, right? So I know this person is a youth speaker, but again, even in the corporate space, I would second that and say, absolutely. Stories of my kids, stories of my personal life, my hobbies, almost invariably outperform some of my straight content pieces. So if those of you making a list of the six best videos that book you more speaking gigs so far, we've got direct to camera. And that first one, was that were those both direct to cameras, or was that one kind of voiceover with B-roll?
The both of them were direct to camera, the audience speaking in the video. We'll get into that. You're giving them a teaser already, Tim.
I know. I'm sorry. I'm revealing. I'm spoiling dinner with my dessert here. All right, let's dive in. Let's go to the next one.
Awesome. The second thing we're going to talk about is you making space into podcast. And basically, there are so many podcasts out there. And guess what? You could start a podcast if there's no one out there that you know who's running a podcast. It's as simple as going into Facebook groups, sharing what you talk about with an amazing picture of you. And you'll find so many people reaching out to you because they want the audience to hear what your message is. If you want, I'd love for you to share something, Tim, about how they can get into podcasts. We'd love to share some insights that we have. But here's how you can convert. Like every single podcast that you approach or every single time that you are on stage or in Zoom call with anybody, that's where your content is. For example, we are into this meeting right now, Tim. We have all this recording. We could create 20 different videos out of this that helps people use videos to grow their business. Right. So the idea is, if you want to share something about how they can get into podcasts, and I'd love to share how they can convert that into amazing videos further.
Yeah, podcasts are really, really easy to get booked on. They need you just as much as you need them. And, you know, whether it's a service like podmatch.com or matchmaker.fm, or really there's a whole bunch of different resources out there, or you can just simply jump on Google, find some podcasts in your topic, in your area, and then start reaching out, because once again, they need you as much as you need them. And as long as you have a packaged message, a piece of content, maybe even a personal story, they're going to want to hear from you. So getting on podcasts, that's the easy part. What do we do once we get them? I love that you said we could turn this video right here into 20 short form videos, and we got to show up where people are, right? Some people like consuming long form content. Some people like consuming short form content. And where are we going to show up if we're not showing up in their scroll feed? That's where people are consuming a lot of content, especially in recent times. So yeah, podcast, easy part, turning that into 10, 15, 20 videos, very, very appealing, leveraging the work that we do and creating lots of output. That sounds really smart.
Awesome. Let's get into it right there, Tim. So as I share my screen, I'm sharing you one specific video. This goes on to be an hour long of podcast. You need an expertise into understanding what good content is. I'll give you a quick 30-second tutorial. The idea is, good content is something that the audience wants to listen to. Well, that's easy, Vaibhav. But what do they want to listen to? They want to listen them, number one, relate to you. Number two, solve a problem that they have or see something that they see in a daily life and you talking about it. As simple as that, right? So if you can talk about these three things, if you can find best parts of your video where these three things are being talked about, boomang, you know, you have an amazing...
Yeah, I gotta jump in here too. This is probably the biggest value you add to me in my speaking business is culling the right clips. That is agonizing to sit and watch yourself speak and try to figure out, how do I say this in 1 minute or less? Or even 90 seconds in some formats. But at the end of the day, that is such a huge challenge to pick out the right pieces of content, and having that work done for me is huge. But, you know, and then obviously you're equipping people, you're telling people everything here. These are the tips for doing that and for finding that. And if they want to do it on their own, by all means, and I appreciate you sharing that. I'm just not one of those speakers who wants to watch myself speak and try to pick out the right clips. And just a little thank you from me to you publicly for helping me with that part of the process.
Appreciate you, Tim. I get, as I said, I was talking to Tim earlier in this call. I've been using so much that I've been hearing. And, you know, that's what we've been doing. That's why we love working with speakers, the message that comes along. We have a team that, like, separate team over here that literally goes on watching all these videos, figuring out what is the part that's most likely to get viral. All right, so let's play a quick video, show you what it would look like, of course, and see how we convert those into high value content.
They may be disappointed, and disappointment is real, and your actions will disappoint people in your life, and it's something, again, you can't control. You can only control your choices and your beliefs. Can't control anyone else's opinions, can't control anyone else's choices, but I would much rather you temporarily disappoint someone in your life than go against your own intuition and 20 years later look back and say, I wish I did the thing that I knew in my heart I really wanted to do. Your parents may get disappointed, but at some point they usually will turn.
Exactly.
And they'll turn around and say, you know what, I was wrong. And even if they don't, I'm sorry, this is your life. You can't live your parents' life.
Quick note on that. The reason the youth audience is going to watch it is because disappointment is what every single teenager, every single high school student feels like. I don't want to disappoint my parents. I don't want to disappoint my friends. I don't want to disappoint myself. And if you can tap into that problem and create a content that works around that, that's what you want to be doing.
Yeah. And again, messaging that matches our audience and having multiple shots at the target. I mean, if many of us don't quite know exactly what niche to target. We don't know exactly what portion of our message to highlight. And when we start producing consistent content, we start getting data and feedback of what types of messages resonate, what types of messages are connecting with our target audiences. So again, in the process of marketing your speaking business, you get better at, you get better marketing materials, and you get better at marketing and diving in, dialing in what your marketing messaging is as well. So I can't stress that enough, the value of having multiple shots at the target. So I can see taking one podcast interview that this speaker was interviewed on a podcast and pulling out a little clip like this is hugely valuable. All right, so we've got two so far. Looking at the time, we're going to have to step up our game a little bit and make sure everybody gets what they came for in terms of all six videos that'll book you more speaking gigs. Let's dive into the next one.
Awesome, right there, Tim. So now when you're done with, you know, let's say you are into direct camera, you have done podcast videos, here's where it gets interesting. The third approach is voiceover with B-rolls, and there are two approaches to it. Number one, if you don't have any stage appearances you have made, you can click a lot of different videos of you doing different stuff. You could be walking on the road, you could be laughing, you could be smiling, you could be dancing by yourself, you could be with your kids, with your partner, you could be at your workplace. Basically, a lot of videos of you different doing different things. And then an audio coming up in the background that is something, again, interesting, inspiring, or something that's a problem-solving content for your audience. And then just using a voiceover over there, and then all of these B-rolls popping up of literally you speaking on the stage and having these B-rolls or your lifestyle, you know. Let me show a quick example so the audience gets to understand what we're talking about here, Tim. So this right here is a video, and let's see it before we talk further.
Hey, brother. It breaks my heart to see you struggle like this, to see you fight this battle in silence. I want to be there for you. I want to support you. I want you to understand that you're not alone. It hurts me and everybody that you love when you don't reach out and ask for help, because we want to support you. We want to see you succeed. We want to see you do well. I want you to know that this will pass, but you don't have to fight this battle alone. I'm right here. If you need me, I'm one message away. You're going to get through this. This isn't the end of your life. It's just one road bump. So take my hand. Let's do this together, okay? I love you, man.
Cool. So that first way to do it, Tim, of you using different B-rolls, of you doing different stuff, and then connecting it to an inspiring message that you want to deliver to the audience and tuning it together into a video that is something that the audience would relate. Or let's say you end up step number two. Yeah, go ahead, Tim.
Yeah, so you can see that's formatted for, you know, cell phones, basically. And you can also notice that a lot of speakers, a lot of professionals, you think of, you know, them traveling through an airport and having B-roll of things like that. And that's something I've begun to start gathering in my own speaking business. And it doesn't have to be that, right? We saw a guy hiking through the woods. I mean, again, whatever it is that brings people into your world. And as you can imagine, that's going to be something that people are going to share with each other and try to encourage each other with your message, which is why we do this. We do this to reach the people with our message who need to hear our message. And when we have the tools like these videos that can be distributed and the audience, the viewing audience can take it and give it to the person that they know needs to hear your message, so powerful. Beyond booking gigs, beyond anything like that, we know that that one person who's out there who needs to hear our message is gonna have a chance to hear it with these types of videos. So whether you got you walking through an airport heading to a speaking gig or you walking through the woods heading to a waterfall, this is a great technique to create videos that matter.
Awesome. Cool. Okay, Tim, now let's get into a second quick format in which you have a stage appearance. Let's say you have been to a speaking gig and you had yourself film talking. This is the other approach to take. You know, there is a voiceover that you make again, and then there are a ton of different B-rolls of you speaking on stage that you can use to create a video like this.
The truth is, the grass is greener where we water it. And comparing our first step to someone else's 100th is a sure way to feel behind. But when we stop looking over the fence and focus on our own lawn, that's when we truly see growth. So empty your backpack, stop comparing yourself to others, and appreciate where you are right now. Everything is happening in your life just the way it's supposed to.
Quickly.
Boom. Hey, I'm going to jump in on this one because this is huge for those speakers who have developed a new program, a new message that they want to bring to a new audience. Let's say you want to break into the corporate space, but you don't have any corporate gigs. Maybe you've got gigs that look like they could be corporate. Maybe you do have gigs where you're doing workshops, speaking on different topics. You can absolutely take that footage and put your new message right over that footage. And that is a great opportunity and a great tool to leverage what you've got and start building it into what you want. Love that example.
Awesome. So
let's make a list. What do we call that? We've got direct to camera. We got podcast interview. We've got voiceover over B-roll. And we've got like personal, maybe your own B-roll, maybe just B-roll. I mean, you guys have all kinds of B-roll that you can tap into. Then you've got voiceover over clips of you speaking, but, you know, doing voiceover. So I think that's a pretty good list so far. Is that four?
Yeah, that's three. So basically, when I say voiceover with B-roll, it's two different formats of it, but we can call it, we can call it four as well.
Okay. All right. We're going to give a bonus then.
Let's go.
Anything else you wanted to add to that?
Yeah, I think that's where we're at. Now, I want to show you some other B-roll format content you can create and get quickly into the final few formats that we have. I know your time is valuable. So the idea is, how do we get you as much as possible in as little time as possible and potentially help you execute all of that into reality as well?
Huge. Yeah. And that's again, some of the set it and forget it of this is just so valuable for speakers who are busy either speaking or busy with life. And being consistent is easy when you're motivated January 1st to start a new thing. Being consistent through the year and when life happens is definitely a huge challenge that a lot of people run into. And again, I'm anxious in all ears to hear even more strategies for taking the content you already have. I'm sure most of our speakers probably have tons of content that they can already tap into or very, very quickly create for a long period of time and put it in the can so that we can drip that content to our audiences over time. So let's let you continue and dive into the next video style. Again, I just love the idea of leveraging our time and being intentional about how we use our time.
Awesome, Tim. Now I want to get into another format of content which is fairly easy to create. Again, the game over here is either using B-rolls of you being on stage or lifestyle. And it happens with me, Tim. In my notes, I have outbursts of moments that I feel really inspired, that I feel really touched, and I feel a message that really hit me well. You know, it could literally be something that you read in a book and you can quote and put it forth as well. What you want to be doing is you want to put all of these B-rolls together. My only request is show yourself. It could be B-rolls of you doing different stuff, or it could be B-rolls of you on stage. Please don't use stock B-rolls for this if you're using it, because if you want your brand to come out, and then you want a text that is really inspiring to be overlapping it, right? And when it is an Instagram and stuff, it overlaps itself. But yeah, that's a quick tip before we get into it, Tim.
Cool. Yeah, I love that point. Show yourself, show, don't tell. This is not just about your message and your speech. It's also about you and the personality and the style and the experience that you bring to audiences. So love that tip. And it's easy enough, once again, to create. Many of us speakers have, you know, files, maybe notepad files on our phones or stuff that we keep in a physical notebook of just things that we get passionate, as you said, bursts of inspiration. I know I've got an articles list. I've got a list of books that I want to write. I've got all kinds of content that I can dip into, turn my phone on, look to the camera without fear of getting it perfect, because I know the editing team is going to make it perfect and get my message out there in a format that people actually consume it. So I love, love, love that burst of energy moment. I think a lot of speakers are going to relate to that. All right, let's go on to the next one.
Awesome. So basically what this would look like is a text coming up and then... So and you see how simple and easy that is to do. If you literally have no editing skill set as well, you can just pull it together and bring it into something like that. Sometimes they end up performing really well because people have to watch it again. And remember, you see the video is just 10 to 13 seconds long, because when it is an Instagram, if that's where your target market is, we can talk about that later, it loops itself. So they watch it again and again. And that's when the algorithm knows that, okay, this is good quality content. But yeah, that's a quick show to you about the text layover B-roll style of videos. And we can hop into some other styles you can approach as well, Tim.
Yeah, I am all in. Let's keep hopping into those other styles. You know, obviously a lot of people think of video, they think of YouTube, but yeah, TikTok, Instagram. I mean, do you have to have huge followings on TikTok or Instagram to really get started with this? I mean, how does that algorithm get started if we don't have a big following?
You build that audience and you build that algorithm out through the videos, not the other way around. You know, of course, and when I say 200 to 300,000 videos, Tim, it's something, it did not happen overnight, you know. I'd be the last person to come in and say that if you just start posting videos in the first month, you'll get all of these results I'm talking about. It's about consistency in the game, right? And if you talk about Mr. Beast, a quick example, it took him 100 videos to get his first 1,000 views, right? Patience is the name of the game. Consistency is the name of the game. If you show yourself out there enough, it is going to lead all of the results that we're talking about, or probably more than that as well.
Yeah, great stuff. Awesome.
All right, Tim, let's hop into the other style of videos again. And this is something super simple. It is literally raw clips. So when you go to the audience, you have a speaking engagement, have someone literally take your camera, and it often happens, it happens with you, Tim, that once you're done with your speaking engagement, there are people who want to talk to you, there are people who want to listen to you further, or you have a moment in your speech, we're not talking about a message, but something really cool happens. I'll give you two quick examples, really quick, of what I'm talking about, and we'll talk about how this is working as well. Again, I can run this over, but the idea over here, Tim, is basically when this video comes up, you want to show the raw side of yourself. You want to be showing what it feels like to the audience.
Can you show us a dance move in it?
You want to show a little bit around what the experience is like when you're speaking in the stage for the audience. Of course, for this one, you have to be in stage or have been interacting with people. And then that's how you create this raw video. The second approach is if people are asking you questions, just have them filmed, right? I'll give you a quick example over here. And let's have a quick watch into this, Tim. So basically,
I've always wanted to be a skater, but this year's been really, really tough for me because, like, I'm going into new school and U14 is, like, the biggest jump in my ski career, and I was getting a lot of bad results, and I was not feeling confident myself, but this meant a lot. Thank you.
You're welcome. Good luck. I hope it goes well.
Basically, it could be literally the audience saying something or you answering to the question that they had for you. Something like this.
Does any part of you like wish you can go back or do anything differently?
I don't have any regrets. I don't wish I could go back and change a thing, because if I chose to believe that, then it makes me waste today. I can't change the past. I can't remove things. I can't go back. So why would I want to choose that negative belief? So for me, like at first it was challenging, but I started telling myself, maybe there's something better. And now I love the work I do. I wouldn't go back if I could. I think this brings me way more joy and fulfillment than soccer ever could have.
You hear that, Tim? The idea is you want to show the raw side to the audience. You want to show what the experience is like of you being in this stage. And of course, the idea is to show what the experience is on top of just you giving in the message over there.
This is so liberating for speakers who, again, think they may not have content to share, and then to see what types of content are, you know, pieces of content are actually working and being shared. It's really freeing. It's really liberating. And all we have to do is just start hitting record, just start documenting what we're already doing, what our lives already look like. And yes, we can pile up or add a layer on our messaging on top of those visuals. But, you know, just the freedom and the flexibility to say to speakers, hey, you know, just start hitting record. Just start hitting record. Let, you know, the editing work its magic. You know, let that selection process and that culling process work its magic. Obviously, we want to be strategic about how we leverage the pieces that we have. But that work's been done for us, right? You do that work, right? For speakers, you've laid out that path and that plan. And we're giving people a lot of the strategies here in this webinar. But at the end of the day, the freedom and the flexibility to just hit record. Just exactly. Hit record. And then, you know, let the magic work its magic. Let's turn it into something cool.
Awesome, cool. So with that said, let's run into the final style of video that we were talking about today, Tim, and that is you speaking on stage. You know, now let's say you're a speaker who does not have a lot of stage experience yet. You have not done a single gig yet. That's not a problem. The idea is you want to have a, even if the audience is not there, you want to be speaking in front of a stage. You could be literally taking the camera and show what the experience is like of having you on stage. Or if you're getting few gigs done, if you're doing your gigs, you want to be recording yourself doing that, and then you can either run it with B-rolls of you, you know, let's say you don't have multiple cameras shooting you, you could have B-rolls that are relevant to what you are saying, or B-rolls of you being on the stage and talking about it, you know. A message, again, the key here is picking in the right message from the long keynote that you have is something that's very important. If we're working with you, we could help you with it, or if you're doing it yourself, make sure the content you're choosing is exactly that the audience wants to hear. Solving a problem, it's interesting, or basically it's something that they can relate to, either of these three. Running into a quick example of this, Tim, and then we'll be having final thoughts and final discussions on our entire conversation about using videos over here. So basically running the video here.
Every time there was an opportunity to dance, I would be the one student sitting on a bench at the side of the gym watching everybody else. Because I carried this belief in my backpack that if I did dance, I would embarrass myself. That if I did dance, I would look like a fool. And so instead of being who I truly was and pursuing the things I was passionate about, I allowed the opinions of other people to keep me sitting on the bench. How are you sitting on the bench in your own life because you fear the judgment of others? It's time you empty those opinions from your backpack.
Exactly. So basically, you speaking on stage, pick out the right clips of it, edit it really well, the right music, the right visuals, get it right. And that's how you have your final format of videos, you speaking on stage. If I may suggest, it is really helpful because it gives the audience, the potential recruiters, the quality of the content you're delivering. It shows what you look like, you know, in terms of excitement, in terms of energy while you're speaking, and also gives a quick sneak peek into what the message is about. So that's what I have to deliver about different styles of videos, Tim. I'm all yours to answer any questions and share details about how the speakers can potentially work with us, and we can help them get the gigs that we're talking about.
Yeah, no, I love this so much. It makes so much sense. And a lot of speakers watching this will have backlogs of presentations that they have recorded, and maybe the video quality is not perfect, but here's the thing. Not one of these six video styles is the traditional standard sizzle reel demo video for speakers. Yeah, we can have those too, and those can be featured on the website and in prominent locations. But when we're showing up where people consume content, when we are using a strategic, proactive content marketing campaign rooted heavily in video, these are the styles that work really well and play really well. And yes, showing yourself on stage and packaging your message. I mean, that's his entire message packaged in that little short bit of empty your backpack of the stuff that doesn't serve you. What is that clip from your keynote that's going to encapsulate you and your message? And, you know, once again, because this is a consistent approach, you're going to have multiple shots at the target. So Happy, if we could just real quick run down the list of the six, if you could list off what the six are for all of our viewers, all of our note-taking types that are wondering which category does this fit into. Let's give them the categories, let's give them the goods. What are the best six videos that book you more speaking gigs specifically with this consistent content approach?
Let's do it. The first is you speaking direct to camera. Take in your phone and deliver the message that you feel most connected to, that your audience, you know, feels like you're talking about themselves or their audience, the problem they're facing. The second is basically using voiceover, putting it with B-rolls. The podcast appearances that you make, Tim, make them really amazing. Find the right clips from them, convert them into reels that you could use. I already touched upon voiceover with B-rolls. You want to use text layover with B-rolls. It could be of your lifestyle stuff or your stage speaking stuff. The fifth one is raw clips. This is the honest side of you, you giving autographs, you giving high fives to the audience, or them asking you questions and you answering for them. And the final style is you speaking on stage and helping with the message that you have to deliver.
Yeah, bingo. No questions for me in terms of why speakers should be doing this. It seems like an absolute no-brainer. It is absolutely timely, it's relevant, it is, again, showing up where people are. and kind of just staying up with the times, right? All of the speakers out there who are, you know, kind of in the old school approaches and the old school ways, obviously this is, it's time, right? It's time to get updated. And let's talk about how speakers might work with you specifically, and really what that might look like, how you can come alongside speakers, support them, and help them in this process.
For sure, Tim. So there are two few ways that we could work with you. If you are in this webinar, you have the link to click about where you can go ahead and see how we could potentially help you. The first step is basically when you have videos that you shoot, you have speech appearances you have made, and you just want us to edit it in the specific format that it's about to reach that maximum amount of people. We could edit it really to the brand essence that you have to get you the most amount of views, to book you the most amount of gigs. And that's the first approach. You could be doing 10, 20, 30 videos a month. We could help you with it. You could hop on a call, discovery call with us, discover how we could help you out. The second approach is basically we helping you with the content strategy as a whole. We're literally helping you film raw videos over a Zoom call. We're hopping into all the gigs that you have made, and that's possible in the first format as well. If your podcast appearances you have made in either of those pathways that you choose, we can select in those best pieces, convert them into reels, and have you help with it. Now, here's the approach, Tim. For the audience, I hate saying, but you can try to do it on your own. It would be amazing, right? You would learn from it. If you don't know anything, it's going to take your time. It's going to take all the effort. But the truth is, the learning curve, time it will take, is going to cost you business, right? And that's where we come in. We have an expertise of doing this, getting the results that I'm talking about, booking you gigs using the video marketing strategy. So if you get to work with us, number one is coming in the editing expertise. But number two is how the content strategy works specifically for speakers, right? And that's where we come in. You can click on the link and have us work with you. What we suggest is consistent action every single month, you know? And here's the game. If for 6 months you're putting in 20 to 30 videos out there and you book no gigs, we are here to listen to you. That's not happening. We have been getting that results for you. We have been getting every single time with all of the clients that we work with. So I'm excited to see if we can get you the results. If you're serious about your speaking business, if you genuinely want people to pay you for the value you have to deliver, consider investing in yourself and see where it takes you.
Yeah, so this is something, again, I've been working with you and your team for a while now and have been keeping you to myself and maybe a few of our select speaker clients. And now really, if you're watching this video right now, that means that you have bandwidth, Happy. That means that you have the availability to take on new clients. And that's huge, right? That's been a big struggle and a big challenge, is really fulfilling the demand. So if you're out there and you're watching this video and you're wondering, well, look at that huge list of clients that if you were paying attention, like I was paying attention, all those different folders with all those different speakers, will I be lost in the shuffle? Well, if you're watching this, if this video is live, that means you do indeed have the bandwidth to accept new people on. And if you're like me, you know, again, you've got a lot of video raw content. You just don't want to go through the time and energy and effort of not just editing those videos, but learning the proper way to edit those videos and doing so in such a way that is not going to lose views. You mentioned there are many different mistakes that people can make along the way that are going to just absolutely kill your view count. And if you don't have the views, you don't have the reach. If you don't have the reach, you're not being seen. If you're not being seen, you're not getting booked. We know that if we want to get booked, we've got to be seen. And what better format to be seen than video? Even if we only get 1,000 views per video, you know, we're able to turn 10, 15, 20, 30 videos per month and be consistent in a way that is professional and profitable. I was trying to combine those two words together. It's professional. And so that's really what I have to add to that, whether, again, you've got the raw materials or if you want help creating those raw materials. If you can't get booked on a podcast, you'll interview them, right? You'll set up that situation where they can get their message out in such a way that is professional. And I love that you're able to support speakers in our Get Speaking Gigs family to do so. So yeah, scroll down, click the link. You'll see the different options and the different packages and the different ways that are available right now to touch base with Happy and his team. And again, I can't think of a better bang for your buck in terms of marketing dollars. I cannot imagine just looking at those numbers and thinking about a $0 ad spend And once again, people are in a situation where they're coming to you because you're taking your content, your ideas, and your passion and your message, and you're planting a flag in the ground. You're saying, hey, this is what I believe. And those people who are drawn to that are much more qualified than, hey, we need a speaker. No, they want you as a speaker. And that changes the whole game. That changes the whole process. You are now a peer and not a pest. You are someone who is not over eager. You are equal to that prospect, and they see you in that way. So their coming to you is much better than you trying to chase down prospects like dogs. How are we going to have them come to us? Plant your flag, shine your light, make sure that you get your message and your passion and your energy out into the space where people are, and let them raise their hands and say, I want more of that. So it's super exciting to think of the possibilities and the potentials. I am not surprised, frankly, by the numbers that you're getting for speakers, new and old alike, established and raw beginner alike, because you have these strategies in place, because you do so intentionally, and you're not just throwing spaghetti against a wall. That is why I'm not surprised by the numbers that you're getting. And that's why we're introducing you, of course, to the Get Speaking Gigs community. We would expect nothing less. So any closing thoughts? Again, I strongly encourage people, the link's right on your screen, and scroll down to the option that fits you and your business and your budget the best. And let's get this process started at least. If you show up, these good things can happen. If you don't show up, you're doing nothing different. You're going to expect the same old results. So I would strongly encourage you to make that connection and get that ball rolling.
For sure, Tim. And one quick thing to share to the audience, if you're right, if this is something you should go for, if this is something you should not go for, here's the thing. If you're confused about it, we'll make sure that you have an option available to book a discovery call. And if you book a discovery call over here, you'll get one video for no cost at all, which is worth a lot of money on top of free consultation. When I sit in for an hour with all of our potential clients, discuss, share ideas, when it's if it's an hour of discussing and sharing this value, I charge hundreds and thousands of dollars. But we get to sit together. I'm going to show how we can specifically help you do videos for you as well. And you get a sample video for free as well if you book the call. So yeah, all in. There's nothing to lose if you're in the pedestal.
Yeah, I don't want to confuse people. I think you said one video is worth a lot of money. That doesn't mean one video typically costs a lot of money. In fact, people are doing the math and they're thinking 20, 30 videos a month, and one video is very, very valuable. That might rack up in their mind. But the truth is, once again, there are, because you're leveraging like raw materials and pieces of content, it's not like you're redoing the work over and over again. Being consistent is actually in many ways easier than starting from scratch every time. So that one video, yes, is extremely valuable, but not super expensive. And again, I think you're going to be shocked as the viewer here in terms of value to investment ratio and the return that you can expect on this type of marketing activity. So I just wanted to clarify that for people. And again, I don't want to pigeonhole you or anything like that. But I think, again, that yes, the value is very, 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 very high for this. But if we get that consistent and we get it going in terms of a package, it's not going to be a huge, huge expense. All right. So that said, any closing thoughts from you? We've got our list of six. We've got understanding of why, if we're going to get booked, we've got to be seen. And I'm hard pressed to find a better way to be seen for new speakers and established speakers alike. So that's why so many of the big names are going heavy, heavy, heavy into the content marketing approach. And there's no reason why we can't compete and hang with the big boys in this process. We've got our secret weapon, right? So any closing thoughts, Abby?
It's really simple, but I think it's important. It's for you to realize that your message deserves to be heard. Of course, you want them to hire you. Of course, you want them to be seen. But by doing videos, you are already changing the world one person at a time, one view at a time. So give yourself a shot, trust your message, and take the leap so you get booked. But more importantly, you inspire the change you ought to bring into this world.
I love that. We will close with that right there. I can't think of a better way to end. Happy, it's been a joy. Thank you so much for spending your time with us today. And we'll speak soon. Take care.
High five.